So today's topic is operational amplifier characteristics and the bandwidth compensation. So this is for the operational amplifier. So we start supplying the operational amplifier. So that will be the R1, RF, RS and forward resistor. And so this is for the input voltage multiplying the voltage gain, so that will be the output voltage. So in this case, the equivalence resistance can be calculated. So this is the R1 paired with the RF, so that will be the equivalent resistance. Therefore, that's how we can draw the equivalent circuit for the operational amplifier. This is for the inverting operational amplifier. So R1 here, RF here, our equivalent must be put here. And this is for the non-inverting amplifier. So we put the input here. Inverting is that we put the input at the negative terminal. Non-inverting is that we put the input at the positive terminal. So in this case, R1, R2, and R equivalent we connect. So this is for the connection configuration of the inverting and the non-inverting amplifier. So in the operational amplifier, sometimes the output voltage or output gain will be changing. So this is we call the thermal drift. The thermal drift means that the offsets are the not constant. The value with the change in the temperature, change in the supply voltage, and the change in the die. So when the temperature change, supply voltage change, and the die change, the output voltage will be changed. So this is what we call the thermal drift. Thermal drift or the offset. So therefore, when there's an operational amplifier, they show there's a capability to reject the noise. This is we call the common mode rejection ratio. So common mode rejection ratio, CMRR, can be calculated AD by AC. So this is the differential gain divided by the common mode gain. So this is for the gain value. And if you can also write the gain in the dB value, so CMRR is equal to 20 log AD by AC. So that this is for the CMRR. Common mode rejection ratio and frequencies are characteristic that we follow the diagram. So in the meantime, when the noise is present at the input of the operational amplifier, a noise gain can also be happen. So the noise in the output voltage can be calculated. Noise gain is equal to RF by R1 plus 1. So this is the general characteristic of the operational amplifier. The starting from the 1 kHz frequency, ending at the 100 MHz frequency, the gain will be the starting from the 20 to the 100, so that we can draw the characteristic gap frequency, response characteristic gap by this way. So that in this case, we can achieve the voltage gain up to the band bound length. The phase shift means that sometimes when we put the input and output, there will be the phase between the input voltage and output voltage can be changing. So this is the phase shift. Phase shift means the phase relationship between the input and output voltages of operational amplifier. So this is we call the phase shift.